Fucking Omar's coming on our show. It's been confirmed.
Oh, yeah? Good. Michael K. Williams, when?
Fucking Omar's coming on our show next
Friday.
Is that
Friday. From our guy?
Oh, we haven't announced Roland on the show yet. Roland's back.
No, I guess we just did.
We sort of did on Twitter and stuff, but Roland's back with the radio show, man. And all of a sudden...
Dino's back! Dino's back!
Guest booking's getting better already.
But is he coming alone, or is he coming with a friend? I requested two together.
Oh, you did.
Who?
I wanted two guys together.
Why am I not watching Boardwalk Empire?
Heyo.
Here it's great.
We're going to get Roland. We're going to get Roland. Yes, Michael, Omar and Roland, they're going to shoot it out.
Oh, you're going to get, we're getting the other guy.
Jamie Hector, who is Marlo.
Marlo, holy shit. Oh, right.
And really? Omar. Yeah. And the fucking...
I'm not going to call him Michael K. Williams, he's Omar.
Where is Roland?
I don't play that shit.
Is Roland here?
I'm going to say, Omar, what's your latest role? That's
these guys do that. These guys embrace their roles. They're great. They don't fucking shun the wire. They like, talk about it. They're cool about it. They're not babies about it.
Yeah, Roland's here. We could say hi to him.
I love Roland. Yeah, I was so happy to hear that we hired him.
Huh?
They're actually taking the money out of my salary. I approved.
I'm not going to hear a complaint here.
No, I don't mind.
Yeah, play his fucking music. Let's get this over with.
When you need radio gold, he's the one that you call. With crappy movie reviews, wears his shirts extra small. The one you can count on the book, a guest for a session. But ends every single sentence he says in a question. No pronunciation, soft-spoken and mumbles. Just try and put him behind the mic and he crumbles. Babbling moron, that's for you to decide. Bonadouche, check him out, Friday Wise. It's rolling. It's rolling. It's rolling. It's rolling.
Yeah.
Roland's back with the show.
Action. Roland is back.
Hello.
Hi, Roland.
Thank you, guys.
Another Springsteen shirt.
Yes.
How many Springsteen shirts would you say you have?
More than 20, 30, 40, probably.
20, 30, 40, probably. Yeah. You doubled it.
Well, now,
it's in the ballpark as, like, you don't even know.
Now that you guys got me a job, I get more Bruce shirts.
Yes.
I pre-ordered the Darkness album because it's like $150.
Why?
What?
It's a special edition.
What's special about it?
Yeah.
You get free t-shirt and poster.
Big fucking deal.
For $150?
Jimmy, how dare you?
What?
This is what you do with Kiss and Black Sabbath.
Oh, that's
it's
true.
It's just a different band, that's
yeah,
all.
Yeah, but it's not the band I like.
So fuck out.
So
Roland.
Now that
but you should
like
understand where he's at with his obsession for a band.
Oh, I do.
Okay, good.
Roland, yes. Now, how long have you been...
Unemployed.
Gone from the show.
Yes, unemployed. It's like a year and change.
Was it that long?
Yeah.
And catch
rent
everybody
too
up.
Too damn high.
Catch
hi-yo.
You look good, though, since the Fort Hood shootings.
Yeah, we weren't commenting on that. What have you been doing? Fill the people in on what your life was like for about a year.
A year of contemplating on losing weight. Didn't happen.
Yeah.
A lot of TV.
Yeah, you watch a lot of television.
A lot
very
of talk
good.
Shows. A lot of chick flicks.
Chick flicks?
Yeah, remember he likes the chick flicks.
Oh, right. What did you like? That was
the Josh Duhamel movie is pretty good.
The what?
The new Josh Duhamel movie. Life as We Know It.
What is it?
It's a chick flick. It was really good.
It's not good.
What was the story, briefly?
Basically, they have a best friend. They had a kid. They die. Then.
Oh, right. Yeah. And they have to step in as the parents, even though they're not in a relationship.
And then they fall in love.
Of course they do. How predictable.
Yeah, the tickle.
Forgot about the tickle.
You know, action, suspense.
Been, been going on interviews and that's pretty much it.
Going out on interviews?
That's how I was doing for the past year and a half.
What were you trying to get? What were some of the jobs you were going for?
There's one at MTV. Took like 7 months of interviews.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
You going for the Jersey Shore?
No.
Roland Carm.
So that didn't pan out, and then the call came in to
the call
return.
Came in here. Yeah,
the bat signal went
everybody
up.
Everybody was very grateful here. So
grateful,
grateful, or nice, and all that.
Supposed to be gracious.
Gracious.
Grateful would be if you came in and they went, "Thank God you're here."
That's funny, Rolls. And everybody here was grateful.
Yeah,
totally get the message wrong.
Grateful and gracious really do mean two different things.
How great would it be if he was fired this afternoon?
So you are going to be booking guests
for you guys.
Here for the program.
Yes.
Who can we maybe hint, even if you got to maybe leave out the name, just maybe Who are we looking at here as far as getting some guests?
There's a couple coming up. I'm trying to lock in and confirm.
Trying to lock in and confirm? Mm-hmm. A-listers?
Yeah.
Would you say?
I say A-listers, yeah.
Current. People would be like, wow, that's current. That's they're working.
Yes, this guy's filming a sequel to a big blockbuster film.
Oh, Hangover 2.
Yeah,
right. Yeah, okay. That's it.
Oh, look at Jimmy.
Right. By the way, when I saw Gerard Butler, we did a lot together. Whatever.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Gerard Butler's a big friend of
I was talking to him about Roland. Yes.
Yes, yes.
I was talking about Crazy Roland is, but he likes you a lot.
Yeah, I emailed him and he said, I'll see you boys soon.
No, it's amazing.
I like to have him come in, that's for sure.
He's next year.
What's amazing about Roland, you think he just bullshits his way through life, and then you do meet like people he talks about, and they all have nothing but things to say about Roland.
They all know him.
Right?
Not nice things.
Once I got the job, David Duchovny called and said he'll see you guys in January.
See? David Duchovny. We've always had a great time with David Duchovny.
If you weren't hired, he'd be here in December. But since you're here, he's putting it back a month. He wants to avoid Roland.
he wants more Legos.
That's right. For his kid.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Obviously, a couple of people not with us anymore here.
Yeah.
Steve C. Yes. Has moved on to greener pastures.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, our security guy who you got along with so well.
Did you get along? Oh, no.
Remember some of the fights? Remember some of the fights that went on?
Oh, sorry, your dog died.
I
try to swamp people to see if I can see him once in a while.
Yeah, right.
You don't want to fuck with Roland.
No, Roland was vicious.
Roland has another side of him.
That was one of the first times we saw it, too. Like, Roland's very mild-mannered.
Do we have that? We haven't played that in a while.
And he unloaded on Master Poe. It was really funny. And that was the first time we saw you really kind of come out of your shell.
Yeah, that one and Eastside Dave. Those were the two. Yeah.
Eastside Dave. Were you friendly with Eastside Dave, though? No. You two didn't really. And he's gone, too. Look at you.
And his wife hasn't forgiven me for that comment, yeah.
Really?
I haven't apologized, though, but I won't.
And you won't?
No.
Why would you?
You got along with Steve?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So yeah, I thought maybe there was some kind of conspiracy going on.
No.
Roland makes people disappear. Can you get Jesse on the show?
Good probably
luck with
yeah.
that one. No.
Yeah, I don't think so.
That one, Roland.
Jimmy wrecked that for
I think
us.
I ruined that.
Yeah, we know you're good.
Jimmy will be sick that day. And then I go, oh my God,
it was
he's here.
Great. It was great. I'm glad. Good. I could watch the show and see what an idiot he is. Yeah, we could just put sound clips on and make fun of him.
I could care less.
His Jesse's to your
Navy
Gene Simmons.
Seal. Yeah, right? Yeah, Gene Simmons. I feel the same way. Keep him out.
I'd be fine with it if he came back, but if he doesn't want to, it gives a fuck.
Yeah.
So irrelevant to me.
You like the corporate environment around here, Roland?
Yeah,
it's different, right?
Yeah, it's different, but everybody's been nice, so.
That's good.
Well, that'll stop. That'll end.
That has to start before it stops, by the way.
The thing I do like about it is that the other shows here, it's like, it is, the XM building was a little lonely. Like, this is actually, you know how you're just saying hi in the hallway, but at least there's always people around, which I kind of like.
I liked the loneliness.
Sometimes.
I like people being able to just come up without having to go through a battery of security and...
We had that scumbag downstairs at the fucking XM place.
Yeah, but he was a building guy, so we could tell him to go fuck himself.
With the tie.
Yeah, that guy. Oh, the pedophile.
That piece of garbage. I hope he's dead. I hope Will Sampson threw a fucking concrete sink on him. Or smothered him with a pillow.
But the things I liked about the other place were the fact that we could throw the windows open and demean the guy sweeping in front of the Directors Guild and call him a piece of shit. That was fun. Remember him getting in the argument with the guy that would sweep the sidewalk in front of the Directors Guild?
You don't think the mustard incident was the greatest
mustard
incident ever?
Mustard was fantastic. It was dumping mustard. Who were you trying to hit?
The stick guy.
Yeah, the guy that had
what
the
was
stick.
It? The toothpicks?
It was a
what the fuck was
stick.
It? Danny, help me out.
Yeah, he had the toothpick art
of David Letterman or somebody.
Yeah, he had a bunch of things that day,
and we had it with him. So I decided to take mustard and just squirt it on him from the fifth, sixth
yeah,
floor.
Yeah, he left, and we
and
were
I
watching.
Hit some Asian gentleman,
Asian guy,
just minding his business, yeah. Coming into work.
That was the same day that Fred from Brooklyn decided to hip check him into the side of the building,
yeah.
But said it was okay because he made eyes at you from six floors up.
I didn't know that.
So you guys were on the same page.
This is the first I'm hearing of this.
Box of Cocks was great.
Yeah. Homeless fishing.
Homeless fishing. Yeah, we can't do that. Oh my God! What was the other one? Nigga or Nazi? Who would get picked up by the cab first?
That video is hilarious.
Like, did you say street fishing or did we?
Yeah, street fishing.
Yeah.
That was just some great shit.
We could do it from here.
$5. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, $5.
The homeless half a Hulk face photo.
Half a Hulk face photo op to get his tumor removed.
$5.
There was so much shit that went on because we were alone and we were able to just hit the street.
Trying to dupe people into thinking that we were walking around with Bono.
Yeah, the Bono guy.
Or a month in when we almost got fired because a girl passed out and paramedics showed up.
Yes! Oh, God, that was so funny.
And I fucked one in what became Ron and Fez's office without a condom.
Yes!
Before, you bet I did, and I came all over the place.
Before it was Ron and Fez's office, it was a sex room.
Oh, yeah. That was the sex room. Horrible.
I fucked a half-passed-out Asian girl.
Remember
poorly, I might add.
Remember the drunk, naked girl that tried to leave by window?
Oh, yeah, yeah. She was walking around thinking the window was a door.
And that was the day where one of them was completely naked on the sidewalk crying for her mommy, basically, as everyone was coming into work.
Ah, the good old days.
The first week of our new jobs, basically.
Yeah, this is different here now. I just want to let you know.
Let's be careful now.
You went to Starbucks and harassed Starbucks.
Starbucks comedy.
The Starbucks comedy where Voss would go in and just do 3 minutes.
And Route 57.
Yeah, Route 57.
He was funny, too.
Yeah.
Well, Roland's back. Congratulations.
Roland. Thank you. Guys,
so good to
so happy you're back with the
thank
team.
You. Exactly. I'm too.
Looking forward to your next Springsteen shirt.
Yeah.
It'll be Monday.
Monday.
That's an old one, right?
It was like the limited edition one I bought for $80 at the concert. Then now I went online this summer, it's $19.
Ooh.
Not very limited.
No.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Hey, are we gonna get Michael K. Williams and Jamie Hector together?
Their schedules are separate, so that's the.
We'll get them separately, though.
Mm-hmm.
That's okay.
I thought we can get them together.
Yeah, but that's okay.
All right,
Roland's back. We're gonna take a break again because we still have to do.